Welcome to a video that will show the relationship between the differential equation dy dt equals k times y and the exponential function y equals c times e to the power of kt. If the rate of change of y with respect to t is proportional to y, then the general solution to this differential equation will be y equals c times e to the power of kt. Again, let's take a look at that again. If the change in y with respect to time is equal to some constant times y, then the solution is y equals c times e to the power of kt, where the value of k here is the rate of growth or decay based upon whether k is positive or negative. C would be the initial value of y, k is the constant of proportionality. If k is positive, exponential growth, k is negative, exponential decay. Now let's take a closer look at this relationship. If we were given this differential equation where dy dt is equal to some constant times y, let's see if we can solve it. The first thing we might try to do based upon the strategy of separation of variables is multiply both sides of the equation by 1 over y. Well, if we do that, we would have 1 over y times dy dt equals 0.12. Now let's rewrite this in differential form. So we have 1 over y dy equals 0.12 dt. Now let's integrate both sides of the equation. The antiderivative of 1 over y with respect to y would be natural log y equals the antiderivative of 0.12 with respect to t would be 0.12t and then plus c. This is a logarithmic equation. If we wanted to rewrite this as an exponential equation, we would have e raised to this power would have to equal y. And let's go ahead and do that. E raised to the power of 0.12t plus c must equal y. Now let's take this up here and work with this a little bit more. Now let's take a look at this right side of the equation. We could rewrite this as y equals e to the 0.12t times e to the c. Remember, when you're multiplying and the bases are the same, you add your exponents. Let's call this small c. E to the small c is equal to some constant. So let's go ahead and let big C equal e to the small c, because they're both constants. So what we have left is y equals c times e to the power of 0.12t. So what we've shown is if we take the time to solve this differential equation in this form, we do get an exponential function where this value of k is the rate of growth or decay in this exponential function. So let's say that again. This equation represents exponential growth. For a business view, this equation models continuous interest, where 0.12 represents the rate of continuous interest, t is the time in years, and c would be the initial investment. So if you invest $2,500 at 12% continuous interest, this equation would model the balance of the account. So if we want to know how much money would be in the account after 4 years, we would have y equals 2,500 times e to the power of 0.12 times t, which is 4, and y would be the balance of the account. So we'd have 2,500, second natural log brings up e, 0.12 times 4. The balance of the account would be $4,040 and roughly 19 cents. Let's take a look at the graph of that. Here we see the graph of the slope field from the differential equation, and then in blue we have the particular solution when the initial investment amount was $2,500. If we invest for 4 years, if we go out to x equals 4 and then go up to the function, here's that value that we found of $4,040. Looks like the point at 3 years is also a graph, but we found the value at 4 years. Let's take a look at one more example. Carbon-14 has a decay rate of 0.01205% per year. The rate of change of any amount n of carbon-14 is given by this differential equation. Now that we know this matches the form where the solution would be an exponential equation, where this is k, we don't have to take the time to solve this differential equation. We know that the function would have to be, in this case, n of t, it's going to be equal to some initial value times e to the power of kt. So here's the value of k times t, which would be in years. So that's what's nice about recognizing when you have a differential equation equal to some constant times the original function, we know it will be an exponential function, and this represents the value of k. So now we can go straight to solving a problem. Suppose 200 grams of carbon-14 is present at time equals zero. How much remains after 800 years? Well, it's quite straightforward now. So C would equal 200 and T would equal 800. And we can go straight to the calculator. So of the 200 grams, so of the initial 200 grams of carbon-14, there is roughly 181.6 grams left. And the last question, after how many years will half of 200 grams of carbon-14 remain? And so that would be the half-life of carbon-14. Well, this is an algebra question. If we start with 200 grams, then the amount after would be 100. We'd have 100 equals 200e to the power of negative 0.0001205 times t, and we have to solve this for t. So we divide both sides by 200. So notice on the left side we have 0.5. That'll always be true for half-life equals e to this exponent. And now to solve for t, we'll have to take the natural log of both sides of the equation. And now we can apply the power property, so we take this exponent and we can move it to the front. So we're going to have natural log 0.5 equals negative 0.0001205t times natural log e, but natural log e is equal to 1. So the last step here is to divide by this coefficient. So let's go back to the calculator one more time. We're going to have natural log 0.5 divided by negative 0.0001205. And it looks like it's roughly 5,752.3 years. Okay, that's going to do it for this video. Have a good day.